Dearly beloved, we are gathered here in the presence of God in this company to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. Our common love and affection for Michaela and Jonathan have brought us together. Today is a special day for them. We want to begin the service by thanking you for being here and by affirming the important contributions many of you have made to their growth and maturity. This service of marriage will affirm Jonathan and Michaela as life partners who will establish a home and fulfill a life together. The words, "I love you," first spoken shyly, are today spoken in full fidelity and commitment to each other. As friends and family of Michaela and Jonathan, if it is your desire to support them as they make this significant commitment, please say, "We will."
We will.
You may be seated. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother.
Let us seek the blessing of God as we pray together. O God of all creation, give us life and love to fill our days with beauty and joy. Look now with your favor on Jonathan and Michaela as they make their vows of love and love. You bless them in their finding of each other and in their growing and maturing love for one another. As this service is a culmination of that love, grant that it may also be the beginning of an ever deeper expression of caring and understanding. Through Christ we pray. Michaela and Jonathan, this glass was a gift to my wife, Beck. It says, "This glass is half full." I think someone gave it to Beck in appreciation for the positive attitude that she displayed. It reminds us that whether we see the glass as half full or half empty depends on our perspective. And the perspective on life that we choose to take makes all the difference. This is the same with marriage. Michaela and John, the perspective that you choose to take in your marriage relationship will make all the difference. As I've learned to know each of you, it's clear to me that your faith in Christ is at the heart of your individual identities. As you and those of us around you know, your Christian faith perspective influences every aspect of your lives. So, in hearing the story of your relationship, it seems logical to me that one of the things that is attracting you to each other was the faith that you share in Jesus and your belief that each day He will show you the way that leads to life. In the Gospel according to John, Jesus promised that the Father would send the Holy Spirit in Jesus' name to teach His followers everything and to remind us of all that Jesus has said to us. Writing to Jesus' followers in Galatia, the Apostle Paul said that the living presence of the Spirit is evident because As we follow Jesus, we bear the fruit of his Spirit in our relationships by treating one another with love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. John and Michaela, your growth together has not been without times of testing and negotiating, times of give and take, times of conflict and reconciliation. Your relationship grew because you shared with one another. You spoke to one another. You dared to reveal who you are to one another. You worked at being able to express yourself honestly. What you've worked at during your courtship and engagement encouraged you to commit yourself to continue as husband and wife. When you find yourself afraid to risk being open about your thoughts and feelings, remember that there is no fear in love, but Jesus' perfect love casts out any fear. A love relationship lives and grows through honest communication with one another. When such sharing freely and regularly occurs, a home can become a safe haven of mutual trust, acceptance, and support. Additionally, home is a place where, as a family, you will have the opportunity each day to affirm your respect, your devotion, and your love for each other, the one who will rock you. The writer of Ecclesiastes highlights several of the benefits of building a faithful friendship. He then writes, a cord of three strands cannot easily be broken. Jonathan and Michaela, your trust in God has given you a new perspective. No makes all the difference in each day of your lives. We trust that God's faithful presence will guide, enrich, and sustain your marriage relationship throughout each day of your life. Having heard these words of instruction, will you, Jonathan, have the favor to be your wedded wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful only to her, so long as you both shall live. Caleb, will you have Jonathan to be your wedded husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, to be faithful only to him, so long as you both shall live. John 13, verses 1 to 17, we read of how Jesus washed his disciples' feet. The job of washing feet was reserved for the servants or slaves of the home. Yet, Jesus, who spoke galaxies into existence, donned the towel of a poor slave and wiped the muddy feet of his friends in a display of love. Jesus also calls us to love by serving and humbling ourselves. As Jonathan and Michaela entered into this new relationship, they've chosen to wash one another's feet. This action is more than a symbol. It is a vow to always humbly love and serve one another as Jesus did. They will also braid a cord of three strands, symbolize keeping God at the center of their marriage. By doing so, they proclaim the belief that God's love will continue to bind them together in the valleys and on the mountaintops of life's journey.